Adobe's been in the news lately, and not for good reasons. People are upset about their crazy cancellation fees and how it feels like they only care about money. Because of that, a lot of people are looking for other options to replace Adobe products. One big problem though is finding something good as Photoshop, especially with its generative AI tools. Most other programs don't have that. But guess what? I found one that does, and it's free and open source. Let me introduce you to Krita, a program made by artists for artists. It got all the tools that are commonly required, and you can even make 2D animations with it. Pretty awesome, right? Getting Krita is super easy. Just go to their official website and download it. It works on Windows, macOS, and Linux. Once it's downloaded, you just install it like any other program.
Easy peasy.
This is Krita. Well, just installing Krita isn't enough to be able to generate AI images. We will need a plugin called Krita AI Diffusion. To get it, go to the plugin's GitHub page, find the releases section, and download the zip file of the latest version. After this, go to Tools, Script, and select Import Python plugin from a file. Then select the zip file that you have just downloaded. Then click on Yes to enable the plugin. Then we have to restart this Krita application. After that, let's create a new image. And here, the very first thing we have to do is to go to Settings, then Dockers, and enable this AI image generation. And because of that, we get this little window on the right-hand side of our application. Now, we need to set up a server to generate AI images. For that, click on this Configure button, and then we have three options: Local Managed Server, Custom Server, and Online Service. Online service is provided by the developers of this plugin. So, if you don't have a powerful GPU or don't want to set up your own server, you can simply create an account on this website and they will give you some free tokens to try out their server. After that, you can get 5000 tokens for 10 euros. Adobe, on the other hand, only gives you 200 credits for the same price. That's a huge difference. But if you have a GPU, you can set up a local server to run it for free. It takes a little bit of work, but it's worth it. So for that, select the local managed server option and then select the folder in which the server will be installed. This plugin tells you that there should be at least 10 GB of free space on the disk. But I would recommend having at least 20 GB because 10 GB is not enough for all the stuff we'll be downloading. Then we can select where to run the server, CPU or GPU. Obviously, it should be GPU. These are the core components that will be installed. After that, we can select one or both of the Stable Diffusion models to download. If you are low on space, just select any one model, but I will go with both of them. Then we need to select the checkpoints. Here, at least one is required. For example, if you just want to generate cartoony images, you can go with this checkpoint. But if you want to generate other types of images, you can download other checkpoints too. Then there are upscalers to upscale your image and the control nets. Select these checkboxes according to your need and at last click on the install button to install it. It will take time depending on your internet speed because we are downloading a lot of files. After the installation is completed, the server will automatically start. So just close this. Now from here, select from the checkpoints that you have installed. Let's go with comic and anime and let's generate a handsome boy like me, blushing after looking at his crush. Click on the generate button and wait. For the first time, it may take longer than usual because the model gets loaded into your computer's main memory. Since I have a 1050 GPU with an i3 third gen CPU, it took me approx 3 minutes to generate a single image for the first time. Then like Adobe's generative AI, there's also an option to make a selection and then remove or add content according to the prompt. Honestly, I just discovered this tool, so I'm also exploring the ways I can use this AI image generation. But we can add content, expand our image, remove content, and do a lot more. What do you think about this? Let me know in the comments.